Hi everybody and welcome to yet another edition of Anything But. In Anything But today, my guest is a Kuliapitiya girl, the daughter of Dorothy and Victor de Silva, and the sister of Darini and Shirani and the late Sanat. You know her as the epitome of grace, of finesse, of dignity and charm. You know her as Ramani Fernando. Hi Ramani, welcome to our show. But Ramani Fernando was once upon a time a very provincial girl from Kuliapitiya. Ramani, what was Ramani de Silva like? Who was she?
Yeah, as you said, I was after 10 years I was in Kuliapitiya, actually 11 years. And I came to the boarding at St. Bridget's Convent at 9 years. So 2 years I was in the boarding. I had a wonderful life in Kuliapitiya. My father was a lawyer there.
He was a crown proctor.
He was
a
crown.
And acting magistrate there.
That's right.
And what was life like at that time?
Well, life was just centered around this community of lawyers, doctors, government servants. And the highlight was the clubhouse, okay, which we meet every day. And our parents play bridge and tennis and that sort of thing. So we had a very carefree, beautiful life, just a small community. And
what about your friends from that era? Are you in touch with them? Who are they?
Well, sadly, I had my best friend was Konsi.
Konsi? Who is who? What about Konsi?
I call her Konsi because she used to go to school with me and okay, she was my class, and everyone used to call her Konsi. So, and my I never changed that name to Konsi because my godmother was Konsi and I used to call her Konsi auntie.
Yes.
But Konsi was Konsi for me.
So there was a Konsi and a Konsi.
That's it.
Wow.
Yes.
Ramani, the highlight of your social calendar at that time were three major landmarks. There was Christmas, there was your birthday, which was 2 days ago, and there's also St. Anne's Church Feast, Thalavila. What was that like, the church feast?
St. Anne's Thalavila was an annual event.
Okay.
So we go for the feast. It's not just only our family, it was the extended families, aunts, uncles. So about six, seven houses, you know, you can see little houses there.
Yes.
We rent them and we stayed there for about 4 days, you know. And it's, of course, it's all to do with religion and, you know, worshipping and all that sort of thing. But then the young ones like us, like we were like 10 years, 9, 10 years, we used to have real fun. And we used to get new clothes, we used to wear these clothes and parade in the evenings, and also there were these shops, you know. So we used
the
to go
shops.
Yeah, the small shops, you know, little bangles and all these knickknacks, and then all these aunts and uncles would give us money. So we go behind them to get this pocket money. And then it's a case of shopping and having lots of fun like that, you know. I'm sad to see that my kids never went through that. You know, I don't think any of these families go through that now.
The closest I had was a real festival in Balavatta. It was huge, yeah, in the early 70s, but yeah, that's also
born. So it's something like that in Thalavila.
Raman, your brother Sarath, who died of a motor car accident when he was 23, had a profound impact on your life. You were the youngest. What was that experience like?
Yeah, Kumar, he was 5 years older than me, but it was just the two of us that was left at home because my sisters married very early and they are like 15, 14 years older than me. So I was quite close to him and he was very protective of me. And that death was such a shock to all of us because we were at a carnival, myself and my mother, at St. Joseph's, and we were waiting for him to come and pick us up, or he was going to spend time and go back with him. And then we got the news that he has had a head-on crash and he died on the spot. This was near Mount Lavinia Odeon Cinema. Mm-hmm. And then 6 months after that, my father passed away because I think he couldn't handle that.
It was a
double tragedy, yes.
Your father, your mother was an accomplished pianist. You are not, you are not, and you are not. And her father had called it a musical tragedy. But what was nice was her brother, Sanat, had memorized all her exam pieces and he played them beautifully by ear.
Yes.
Right?
Yes.
So you came to St. Bridget's Convent and then there, all your hostelers were your guinea pigs. You shaved their legs and you plucked their eyebrows. And you hated sports, right?
I just couldn't stand to be outdoor.
You got the sun now. Talking to
still, sweating. I'm a bit worried about that. Okay, I hate to sweat. Hate the sun. Okay, so that was yes, boarding. I loved the boarding life. I was there just 2 years, and you know, get punished
by the toilet when you had to do sports.
Yeah. I used to always go into the toilet and, you know, spend my half an hour there, or, you know, vanish somewhere, or go and help in the office or something like that. You know, just to get away from that. And to tell you more about it, you know, I should never exercise. And when Rajit Sweva called me to go for a walk, I should never do that. only after I hit 50 that I started exercising.
Ah, now yeah. It's time too.
Yes, and I just love it now. And yes. Ranjit can't believe that I'm, you know, into this exercising and kind of addicted to it.
Do you understand cricket?
Not much at all.
How much of cricket, with a husband like Ranjit, how much of cricket do you understand?
I would say like 50% really, if I, you know, honest about
50%
it.
50% of yes. 40 years of
and when I ever ask him a question about cricket, he just gives me a brief answer. He knows it's not worth explaining to me. So that's how much I know cricket.
So back to your school days, what was your worst memory at school at St. Bridget's Convent? Where Indu Dharmasen was, I think, Miss Indu Dharmasen was at the time, a few years younger than you.
Yeah, she was a few years younger, but she was a lovely girl, a lot of fun. I was very fond of her, yeah.
And he's a nice guy now, isn't he?
A nice girl. Of course, I never have an awful moment. I hardly studied, I must say. I was always into this beauty and, you know, and as you know, I should do the girls' eyebrows in the boarding.
So was it allowed hostelers to have
no,
shaved
not at all.
Plucked eyebrows and shaved legs in a hostel?
No, this is the passion I had, and I used to get hold of them and do this and get into huge trouble. Ooh. And even they used to even call my mother, she was in Kuliapitiya, call
oh,
and
no.
say, what is this your daughter is doing? You're wasting your money on this girl, you know. So this is the passion I had from my very small days, you know. I couldn't help it. And if there's a school play, I'm the hairdresser, I'm the makeup artist, you know. The
so this passion has continued many, many years down the line. Okay, Ramani, you can go and do your quick costume change. We catch you very soon on the show.
Okay.
So this is Anything But with the Kuliapitiya girl, Ramani De Silva, now Fernando. We meet you very soon, having breakfast, post-breakfast lunch in her salon on Anything But on Kuliapitiya.